Okay.
So we know that people are risk averse. They dislike risk. Now let's go ahead and talk about how people can deal with the fact that the universe is an uncertain place. So let's think about insurance. So let me go ahead and construct just a real basic little example here. And obviously this is sort of a parable, I guess you would call it here. And let's say we have a village of homes. Each home has a 1 in 100 chance of fire. And if there's a fire, there's $100,000 of losses. So, one thing to notice here is the idea of what we call the expected loss. So the expected loss here is the chance or probability of the negative event, the accident, the fire, in this case, times the amount of the loss if the fire happens. So in this case, the expected loss is 1 in 100 times 100,000, and 1 in 100 times 100,000 gets us to, I believe, $1,000. So there's a $1,000 expected loss. Now obviously, it isn't the case that everyone loses $1,000 per year. 99 times out of 100, you lose zero, and then one time out of 100, you lose $100,000. So there's that uncertainty. And insurance is a way of dealing with that uncertainty. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go ahead and have a village insurance fund, and each villager pays $1,000 into the communal fund. And whoever has a fire wins the money. Now, obviously, you know, winning here is not something you actually want to have happen, but at least if you have the fire, you win the money out of the fund, and in that case, you're actually going to go ahead and break even. So then, if there's a fire, you paid $1,000 into the fund, you lost $100,000 due to the fire, and you gained $100,000 winning from the fund. So what happens then is that you're out $1,000. You lose the expected loss. If there's no fire, then you paid your $1,000 into the pot. You didn't lose anything to fire, and you didn't win any money out of the pot, so your losses are $1,000. So, insurance allows us to basically eliminate risk, economically speaking. Now, obviously, there are things that insurance can't compensate you for. You might lose precious heirlooms, or, you know, your cat might die in the fire, or, God forbid, a relative or something like that. But it does allow us to eliminate economic risks. And notice that there's this sort of paradox. Buying the insurance, you're basically making a bet. When you buy insurance, you're making a bet that something bad's going to happen to you, because you're putting some money down, and if nothing bad happens to you, you lose the money you put down. And if something does bad happen to you, you win a bunch of money called your insurance payment. So, but because it's a bet that pays off when you need the money the most and when other bad things are happening to you, it's actually a bet that reduces your overall risk level. It's what we call a hedging bet. So if you hear about someone hedging their bets, that means that they're making a bet that goes opposite the other risks that they're exposed to. When we talk about insurance, a question comes up of, is the premium an actuarially fair price? So actuarially has to do with calculations of probability and loss in insurance. So you may have heard of someone who, say, an insurance actuary who goes out there and calculates what's your chance of getting in an accident and so on and so forth. So the actuarially fair price is equal to the expected payout. So in our previous example, the expected payout was $1,000. So $1,000 was the actuarially fair price. We also sometimes call the price you pay for insurance the premium. So we could also say the actuarially fair insurance premium. Now, if the insurer charged actuarially fair prices, then the amount of money they collected from their clients would exactly equal the amount of money that they paid out. That wouldn't leave them with any profits, and it wouldn't even leave them with any money to pay their expenses of processing the checks and paying out claims and answering the phone and so on and so forth. So it pretty much has to be the case in the real world that any insurance program has to be less than actuarially fair, that firms have to charge a markup above and beyond the actuarially fair price. And this would even be true if we had, for instance, the government having an insurance program like unemployment insurance or Social Security, because there are some resources that are used up in the administration of the insurance program, it can't pay out as much as it collects. So no real life insurance is actuarially fair. So in fact, in some ways, insurance is not just a bet, it's also a losing bet on average, because you pay your money in as an insurance premium. Some of that is used to pay for administration, and if it's a for-profit company, some of it goes to profits. And on average, you know, you might see that a health insurance company might pay out 80 cents of healthcare benefits for every dollar of premiums it collects or something like that. So it pretty much just has to be that way, regardless of whether or not it's a for-profit or non-profit insurance scheme. Nonetheless, because we know that risk-averse people dislike risk and they're willing to pay to avoid risk, insurance may lose you money on average, but it pays out when the money is most valuable to you. So you gain utility on average. And that gets a little bit tricky out there. Okay, so we'll go ahead and stop there, and the next video segment, we'll talk about some problems that occur in insurance markets.